Okay, guys, let's take a look at this GDPR cookie compliance plugin by Moove Agency. Quick disclaimer, I know how to set up this plugin for me. I live in Finland, I live in the EU, so I know what kind of rules and regulations apply for my website. But if you want to make sure that your website complies with your local privacy regulations, please do your own research. This video is just a look into the settings of the free version of this plugin. At the end of this video, we'll take a look at the premium options too. We start with branding, and this is pretty self-explanatory. Some style options, nothing very expansive here. This CDN base URL here is only if you're using Litty Lightbox plugin. Otherwise, you don't have to worry about it. Next up, it's cookie banner settings. Cookie banner is by default turned on, and this is the text that we see on it. Down here are different buttons that we can enable. I'll show you the out-of-the-box experience. This is it. You can see the text here. We have a link to the settings and a general accept button. Let's change this up a little bit. So I need to, GDPR pretty much clearly states that I need to have a reject button enabled. And I can change the order of the buttons here like this. And of course, I can change the text. And we have here also a dedicated settings button. So I'll take the link out of here. I'll remove this link and say that you can switch the cookies off in the settings. And always remember to save changes before moving on. So if we take a look at it now, you can see we have the reject button here at first, and then we have the dedicated settings button that takes us to this general settings window. Next up, it's floating button. Let's enable it. And as you can see, we have some styling options here, visibility on mobile. And what this floating button is this here in the lower left corner. GDPR states that I need to provide my visitors the opportunity to change their settings at any time. So, strictly necessary cookies are enabled. But if I want to, I can go back and disable them. Now, here we are at the general settings, the window we just left. And you can see we have some layout options here, nothing dramatic. We have reject all button. This is always good to have. Text changes. We can change the order of the buttons again. Pretty handy. And here's the checkbox labels also. You can change them. Consent expiry means that how long does it take for these settings that the visitor has chosen to reset? So if you put zero here, it means that all those settings that they chose will be reset at the end of the current browsing session. Next up, it's privacy overview, and this is just a text that we can see in the general settings window. And remember, you can insert a link here if you wish to, for example, link your privacy policy here. Quite handy. So, next up, it's strictly necessary cookies. And what these cookies are basically are the cookies that this cookie compliance plugin uses to save the selections that the visitor makes in the cookie banner. And I think in this case, it's always good to just select always enabled. We kind of need these in order to run this whole banner. Next up, it's third-party cookies. Now here in this window, we add the scripts that we need for our non-necessary cookies. For example, Google Analytics. If you set up Google Analytics account, you will receive a script from them. And usually the Google Analytics script is placed in the head section of each page of your website. But instead of placing it there, you can place the script. And I have here a dummy script like this. So instead of placing this into the HTML code of your page, take it out if you've already placed it there. Take it out and place it here. And now we'll turn on the cookies in the banner, and default status is disabled. I think this is for GDPR. This is necessary for the default status to be disabled. We can change the names here. We can say analytics cookies, and of course, we can add more scripts here if we have other analytics cookies that we want to use, and different sections according to where they're supposed to be placed. But now we place the Google Analytics script here in the banner, so it's controlling it now. So let's take a look. We have a new section here, Analytics Cookies, disabled by default. We can enable it. There you go. Handy. And the next section, Additional Cookies, is just another label under which we can put more scripts. As you can see, it's completely identical to the previous section. Last section here is the cookie policy. We can turn it on, and we have here a link. I'll show it to you. We have a link here, cookie policy, to the cookie policy that actually is created by automatically by WordPress. And quickly, we'll take a look at the premium options here in orange. Multi-site settings, if you're running subdomains, this is very important for you. You can use the same settings across your subdomains. Geolocation allows you to show the cookie banner to visitors from specific parts of the world and then deny the cookie banner from other visitors. An iframe blocker, for example, if you're embedding a Google map on your website, if you want to block these functionalities by default, then you need this setting here. And last but not least is the consent log. For example, GDPR states that if a visitor wants to see their history of their choices, their settings on my website, I have to provide this history to them. So this consent log allows me to do it, and it's quite important, right? And in this plugin, it is, in my opinion, unfortunately, hidden behind a paywall. And one more thing I'll show you is I just installed a Polylang language plugin. So you can see that the GDPR plugin detects that you're using a multi-language setup. I have two languages, English and Finnish. So at the moment, I'm using the English version, so I can change the texts according to this now. So I can say, This is English. And let's switch to Finnish and say this is Finnish. And if we quickly change the settings here so I can show you the actual banner on the site. Let's disable, so we should see the banner now. There you go. We have the English version of this banner here. I'll switch it to Finnish. And we have the Finnish version of the banner here. So this works well with Polylang and also with WPML, according to the documentation of this plugin. So that's it. I hope you found this useful. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.